What's going on, boxing fans? Julian Williams here with the Distance Cut video for you guys. This is one of my final predictions for this year. This is for the upcoming bout between the WBA Junior Lightweight Championship between Takashi Uchiyama and Jorge Solis. This is actually a really good fight. It's going to take place like on December 31st in Japan, I believe. And like I said, for the WBA Super Featherweight Championship, Junior Lightweight. Uchiyama is a fighter, is pretty much, you know, he's a Japanese fighter. He won the belt about almost 2 years ago when he faced Juan Carlos Salgado. Juan Carlos Salgado was pretty much well known for that one-round knockout over Jorge Linares. But, you know, Takashi Uchiyama is a decent fighter. He stands straight up. Fights very well behind the jab, puts his punches together quite well. He's not going to put together like 3-4 punch combinations, but he's effective with, you know, what he throws. He only throws like 2 punch combinations. You know, it's usually a 1-2 or a double straight right hand. He's good at that. He's not necessarily that extremely aggressive fighter that's going to come forward and pour it on his opponent, but whatever he lands is going to be effective, and he's the type of fighter that won't throw unless he knows he's going to land. He's very precise with his punches. He's very, you know, he's very calm in the ring. He's very poised. So in this fight against Jorge Linares, I think this is a fight where he has to work behind the jab. Majority of his punches come, you know, right down the middle. You know, he stands up, he throws his punches straight. Within close proximity, he's throwing the left hook. Or he's going to the body or looking, or when he sees it, you know, he'll throw that uppercut. In this specific fight, you know, against Linares, he's going to want to get his jab off first. He wants to get his jab off first, and he wants to stand, you know, at a mid-range and from time to time fire off the right hand. The right hand may set up the left hook in this fight. Or the jab, of course. The jab may set up the left hook. But I think the key to beating the Jorge Linares, of course, is speed, but also good timing. You know, you have to have good timing to beat Jorge Solis. You have to have good timing to beat Jorge Solis. And also, you have to have, you know, some pretty good calculated movement and know where you are in the ring at all times. So, in this fight, you know, he has to work behind the jab. He has to use the ring a hell of a lot. I think, to be honest with you, I think that, you know, even though I think he could use the ring and fight going back off the jab, I think more than likely he's going to want to fight at the center of the ring in this one. The center of the ring works because, you know, he's working behind the jab. He's putting together his combinations. He's being patient and also probably going to look to counter Solis. So in this fight, you know, he wants to stand up, jab, look for the right hand, look for the counter left hook, but also look to go to the body as well against Solis. Maybe slow him down and find some openings up top because Solis can catch some shots on the glove and release, you know, one big punch. So I think that's really all he has to do is stand, work behind the jab at the center of the ring, look for the counter left hook, counter Solis's right hand, and from time to time just use the ring. And pretty much that's really all I could say for Uchiyama in this fight. This fight is a typical fight. Most punches coming straight, patient, and not really taking a step back. You know, just standing up and controlling the fight with the jab, behind the jab. On the other hand, you have Jorge Solis. Jorge Solis is a pretty good fighter. He can be aggressive. He's another fighter. He puts his combinations together very well. He'll throw a lot more punches than Uchiyama, but also, you know, and also has a decent counter right hand. But, you know, the thing with Solis is, like I said, he has trouble with fighters that have speed. In this specific fight, he wants to fight this one within close proximity to Uchiyama. He wants to go to the body very early because Uchiyama does have this tendency to go into fights and later control the fight just by using his jab, by standing up and jabbing. So Jorge Solis, who, of course, has been in the ring, I believe, with the better competition, is going to have that a bit of that experience advantage in this fight. to where he can come inside, to where he has to come inside and he has to go to the body. He has to go to the body early to kind of take some steam away, take the steam away from Uchiyama late. And, you know, pretty much I think this is a fight to where he has to come after Uchiyama. He has to touch him. He has to touch him. He has to go to the body. He has to, you know, look to throw 3-4 punch combinations, you know, and they don't have to necessarily land, but he can continuously throw 3-4 punch combinations. And as he's throwing 3-4 punch combinations, he's looking much better, you know, compared to the 2 punch combinations that Uchiyama will throw. And Uchiyama tends to wait a lot. So as he's waiting, he can just walk up, you know, walk inside and just start, you know, throwing and going to the body and making this a rough fight. I think that's pretty much the way to beat Uchiyama, is making it a rough fight. You know, take his jab away. If you take his jab away, then you're going to take his right hand away. And you're going to take his combinations away. So if you get in close proximity with him, you know, all he's going to have is that left hook, and he shortens up the left hook, you know, very well. So he has to. So the thing is, he wants to fight inside the entire fight. He doesn't really want to stand on the outside with him. He just wants to fight some inside. And he wants to attack Uchiyama in this fight. So who I think is going to win this fight? I'm going to go with Jorge Solis in this fight. And the reason I'm going with Jorge Solis is because I think he's going to be the more aggressive fighter in this one. Now, of course, coming into the fight, there's going to be, you know, there are going to be defensive liabilities with Jorge Solis. He does get hit, you know, that's another thing. He does get hit, you know, he tends to get hit with the hook. But, you know, I think that in this fight, he's going to come in and he's going to be a little more aggressive. He does have fast hands. He does have fast feet when he's walking in. And I think that, you know, being in there with, you know, fighters like Pacquiao and Gamboa, you know, fighters with a lot more speed than Uchiyama, and I guess, you know, with both of them better timing, I think that Solis could come into this fight if he's not a damaged goods fighter. And I think he could come in and win this fight. I think he just has to take this fight to him. Fast hands, fast feet, and a very aggressive approach. And I think he should pull it off. So I'm going with Jorge Solis being the new WBA super featherweight champion. So anyway, peeps, I'm out of here. That was The Distance. Thanks for watching. Peace.
Everybody put 3 fingers in the air. The sky's falling, the wind is calling. Stand for something or die in the morning. Section 80, high power. Visions of Martin Luther staring at me. Malcolm X put the hex on my